Welcome. In this video, I will briefly show how to make decisions based on expected value using this payoff table consisting of costs. I will also show how to calculate the expected value of perfect information when payoffs are costs. To calculate expected values, we need the probabilities of the states of nature. Suppose the probability for S1 is 0.3, 0.5 for S2, and since the probabilities must add up to 1, we know that the probability for S3 is 0.2. The expected value for the decision alternative D1 is calculated as 0.3 times 12 plus 0.5 times 9 plus 0.2 times 13, and that gives 10.7. For D2, the expected value is 11.6, and for D3, it is 12.5. Since the payoffs are costs, we make decision by choosing the alternative with the lowest expected value, and that in this case is 10.7. So the decision is to choose D1. Now, the expected value of perfect information is calculated as the absolute value of the difference between expected value with perfect information and the expected value without perfect information. That is, if we have perfect information about the states of nature, how much is that information really worth, on average? The best expected value obtained earlier, that is 10.7, is the expected value without perfect information. The expected value with perfect information, EV with PI, is calculated based on the idea that we know the state of nature that will occur with certainty before making the decision. So if we know S1 is going to occur, we choose D3 because it has the lowest cost of 5. If we're certain S2 will occur, we choose D1 since it has the lowest cost of 9. And if we're sure it is S3, we choose D2 at the lowest cost of 8. The expected value with perfect information is thus calculated as 0.3 times 5 plus 0.5 times 9 plus 0.2 times 8. And that gives 7.6. So EVPI is calculated as the absolute value of 7.6 minus 10.7, which gives the absolute value of negative 3.1, and that gives 3.1. Note that in profit problems, EV with PI is generally higher than EV without PI, so the absolute value may not be required. But it is important in cost problems because EV with PI is usually less or equal to EV without PI in cost problems. And that's it. Thanks for watching.